It seems that in recent months, I've been seeing a lot of these YouTube videos going up with different titles like, you know, don't learn scales and don't learn chords. And there's one I saw that said, you know, don't learn theory. You know, I'm going to give all these YouTube video posts the benefit of the doubt in that they're probably just clickbait titles and the authors are just actually, you know, they're not serious about truly saying and promoting an idea of don't learn all this stuff. It's kind of, you know, the important stuff of learning to play. But I think what I wanted to get at in this week's episode of the Guitar Blog Insider is just how beneficial it is to put in a ton of hours, a ton of practice, and also how it changes your playing to go and really study in depth with chords and scales, arpeggios, and music theory. It makes a huge impact in your playing. Well, before digging into all this and really getting heavy into this topic, let's just take a step back and think a little bit about how people just get into guitar in the first place. I think most guitar players begin learning the guitar for fun. You know, something piques their interest. Maybe it's a friend that plays and it inspires them to pick up the guitar. Or maybe, you know, they'll go somewhere and maybe they'll go to a campfire thing and some people are playing guitar and they're feeling like, wow, I got to learn how to do that. Or it could be any other number of things. Maybe it's a movie they watched, guitar was featured and inspired them, or maybe it's just listening to a certain song, you know, on the radio or something, or maybe they found it on their, you know, playlist and they're kind of like, you know what, I'd love to know how to play that song on guitar. You know, so something begins with that spark of inspiration. But, you know, however that interest of guitar takes hold for a person, something in them, you know, it makes them feel like they got to learn, they got to practice, they got to study, they got to get a guitar and get into this whole business. And, you know, after getting a guitar and trying to learn for a while, a lot of times what happens is people are kind of blown away with how challenging it is to actually develop the skills to play well, you know, to be able to play guitar effectively. And, you know, around that point, in a lot of cases, generally that's when they go searching for information. Probably, you know, the most popular thing to do is get a teacher, and they call upon that teacher to, you know, really shed more light on the details and the technique and, you know, the general skills development. And that is where the learning curve begins. Well, I think a lot of us would probably agree who've played guitar for a while that the real trick to getting this instrument down and really getting good at it is exposure to a lot of material and a balance with that exposure to material where you're getting, let's say, songs and things that are fun to play, you know, playing by ear and jamming on things, jamming with other people. That's the one side. And then the other side is more of that academic side where you're doing like a real structured approach using some kind of a curriculum and you're going through everything step by step and you're learning things in the correct order, because believe it or not, there is actually a correct order to learning this stuff. And I didn't really fully comprehend that until I went to music college. You know, when I went out to LA and I started attending the Musicians Institute and getting the curriculum and just seeing how they laid it out, you know, week by week, we were getting handouts of different classes that I was taking in rhythm guitar and improvisation classes and single string technique and all this stuff. And it made so much sense when I was actually getting the material in this very orderly, logical approach. So, you know, once a practicing guitarist begins getting more technique down and they learn several songs and more about all kinds of these ideas that surround the guitar, and that includes lots of stuff, you know, like using a capo, using a slide, and learning, you know, all the technical stuff like bar chords, movable scale patterns, arpeggios, and then down the road, you know, doing key signature theory on the neck and, you know, operating all over the fingerboard with your octave intervals and all that stuff. You know, at that point, usually a guitarist starts feeling that they're ready, you know, to get more serious about playing in respect to doing really improvisation, you know, just really playing from the gut, playing from the heart, and learning how to play solos, you know. So the whole process of learning some information, you know, it just bleeds over to wanting to learn even more and more and more information till eventually the guitar player is pursuing, what other name I could call it, but advanced material, you know, for a much deeper, really in-depth study of the instrument. Now, when this happened to me, you know, when I hit that level where I started feeling like, okay, I really need to get to the next sort of advanced plane of things, I found a teacher in my city who was, you know, sort of one of the top jazz guys and all that, and I started taking lessons with them. And after a while, he was a really good player, and I asked him, like, what's the most complicated, in-depth book that you've ever studied from? You know, I just figured that if I could study from the same book as him, I'd get as good as him, you know, because he was a great player. So he told me the most challenging book that he ever studied from was by an author named Howard Roberts, and it was called Super Chops. This is actually the book right here. Super Chops, Jazz Guitar in 20 Weeks. This book is so thorough. Like, it's just got so much information, and the way it's laid out is so unique, you know, the way the breakdown is. And, you know, it's got pieces, it's all done in traditional music reading. So you get the piece, you get an idea of some, you know, lines to play over it. The book is monstrous. I mean, like, to be able to work through this thing, it's not going to take 20 weeks. Like, I mean, for most people, it's just going to kill them after like 3 weeks, you know, if you even make it that far. So, you know, this book was the first pinnacle turn, you know, like the first area of learning where it just absolutely, you know, kicked my head in terms of learning guitar. Now, the benefits of doing the Super Chops program are incredible because the entire process is based around following chord changes in all of the different areas of the guitar neck using scales and arpeggios. So the Super Chops method takes a very involved chord progression that you first need to learn well enough to go and record a backing track of. And believe me, these chord progressions are not easy to play. They are chops busters, to say the least. And then, anyway, you know, once the backing track is organized, your next goal is to play over all those chord changes repeatedly over and over again until you can consistently perform the associated scales or arpeggios that relate to it, you know, in time across the whole chord progression. The work involved is nothing less than incredibly time-consuming, but the payoff that you get from studying the Howard Roberts Super Chops method is absolutely amazing. So let me give you a quick demonstration for how this works using a very basic explanation. Now, this is way, way under what's in the Super Chops book, but even if you don't own the Super Chops book, you can still do the workout to a certain extent at home and get some benefit from the concept of it all. So we're gonna begin here with a chord progression. I'm gonna use the backing track chord progression in D minor. And what's going to happen with the progression, we're just going to take it from a D minor chord into a B flat major 7, and then we're going to go down into a G minor 7, and then we're going to take a C dominant chord to kind of turn things back around. So it's pretty straightforward chord progression: D minor, B flat, then the G minor, and then the C dominant 7th. Okay, and then once the changes are learned and developed, you know, at a decent tempo, record them. And then once they're recorded or put into a loop pedal or something, you can start phase two of the whole Super Chops process, which is playing over the changes in kind of a robotic way. You know, in the book, it is talked about a lot on just using straight eighth notes. So, you know, if you got a D minor 7 chord, just outline it with eighth notes. Next chord up, B flat major 7. So just outline that. And then next chord is G minor 7, so you just outline that one. Last chord is C dominant 7, so just outline that. Right, and you just kind of keep going, maybe move to another end of the neck afterwards. And just, you know, keep following the chord changes along your guitar fingerboard. What I'm going to do is I'm going to fire up the loop pedal and just kind of demonstrate that for you. I'll just sort of play those arpeggios through that I was just working on and give you a good idea on how, you know, it all come together. So here we go. The idea, you know, it's kind of was following along those arpeggios that I just talked about, and it's kind of an easy process if you know your neck. You know, if you don't know your neck, if you don't know your scales, if you don't know your modes, if you don't know your arpeggios, man, you're gonna be a lot of trouble. Like, you know, even if you don't know how to play these chords, you know, just to do the chord progression, and you got work to do, man. It's all pretty straightforward stuff. So you can tell what I'm doing, though, is I'm not in approaching this, I'm not pardon me, I'm not using phrasing devices like hammer-ons, pull-offs, slides, all that stuff. And you can embellish things as you go on and you get better and better, you know, once you have a handle on this side of playing. But, you know, start branching out as you go and get more comfortable with, you know, playing the changes. You could just even play the straight scale. You know, you could just sit there and go D minor scale, you know. Just do something like that, or maybe practice blending one scale outline to another scale outline, you know, connecting different areas of the neck and all that stuff. So there's lots of ways to start, you know, simply. Don't, like, I started with arpeggios there, but I mean, if you're not familiar with arpeggios, then maybe that's too advanced for you. You know, you just start with something more basic. But, you know, go through things at first in a very sort of more robotic way like that, and then start branching out, playing over the changes more, you know, free improvisational nature. And, you know, at this point, you're going to start becoming so well aware of how everything's laid out on the neck. I mean, your learning of the fingerboard is going to be just through the roof. You know, you'll just be able to develop anything you hear in your head after a while because your knowledge of the neck is going to be so fluid, you know. But, you know, I'll just fire up the loop again and just kind of play over these changes, you know, kind of use a couple of positions and just, you know, just have some fun with it now. And, you know, I'll, you know, use that to take things out here. So here we go. Super Chops program from the book is a lot more intense than what I've just shown you here. The book's progressions are really long. You know, they can be 35, 42 measures long, you know, and the examples of all have melody lines that are associated, so you need to learn those. And you know what? They're all written in traditional music notation. There's no tabs, so you'd also have to be a good music reader to be able to understand what's on all those pages. The chords are all written in notation as well, so you just have to know how to read music to do that program. Now, I know this sounds like an unbelievable amount of work, but what I wanted to get across in this video is that there's really no substitute for serious guitar study. You know, great players, they don't pass over work on scales and chords and theory and technical skills. They actually dedicate many, many, many long hours to it. And, you know, the development of their ability is, you know, it's pinnacle. It's everything to them. And that's why the greatest guitarists are also, you know, so well known as just such fantastic players. They've worked very hard and they're very serious about how they study the guitar. Well, I'd like to wrap up by just saying thanks. Thanks for joining me. Thanks for watching the video. If you want to learn more about what I do as an online guitar teacher, then head over to my website. It's creativeguitarstudio.com. That's creativeguitarstudio.com. You can go there, sign up for your free lifetime membership. And when you want more, you can always upgrade to either the basic monthly package or you can take out the premium package, which saves you $60 on an annual membership. And you get a free guitar care and maintenance ebook. And on top of that, you get access to absolutely everything on the website, and you can just start digging in and studying all the guitar courses that I've organized for the members of creativeguitarstudio.com. So anyway, I'd also like to hear your thoughts on everything I talked about in this video. Please leave some comments in the comments section below. Let me know what you think about your own ideas on how you got started in guitar, what you think is important if you're a serious player, all that kind of stuff. I'd like to know what your thoughts are. And overall, if you enjoyed the video, please give it a thumbs up and subscribe for more. Otherwise, thanks again for watching, and we'll see you next week on another episode of the Guitar Blog Insider. When it comes to online guitar lessons, there's no place better than creativeguitarstudio.com. General membership to the site is always free, and paid memberships to access our step-by-step beginner, intermediate, and advanced guitar programs are offered in reasonable monthly and annual packages. Skype lessons are also available if you need more specific instruction one-on-one to discuss the finer details of your guitar playing. Sign up today at creativeguitarstudio.com. I've got 25 years experience teaching guitar and have written a well-organized step-by-step guitar course. Head over to my website at creativeguitarstudio.com and sign up for a free membership today. Join the thousands of members worldwide who have already enrolled. There's no need to try learning the guitar on your own. Let me help you become the best guitar player that you can be.